A grim picture of the ANC's chances in some regions ahead of this year's local government elections. Now, this comes after the ongoing fights within the structures of the ruling party regarding the selection of candidates in some wards across the country. Now, for more on the story, we're joined by Zizi Kodwa, the ANC spokesperson. A very good morning to you, sir, and welcome.
Thank you very much, Alvis. Good morning to you.
Now, first, I believe you're now in Cape Town because we were supposed to have you in PE. Are you okay where you are right now?
I'm 100%. In fact, immediately after this interview, I'm on my way to PE.
Yeah, no, you're a very busy man. Now, let's get back to the interview. We have recently seen some protests in the Tshwane region that were related to a selection of the potential candidates there within your ranks. What is the real cause of this?
Well, I think if you were to look back in 2011, because the selection of candidates is quite an intense process. There are personal ambitions. There are those who see it as nothing else but an opportunity for deployment, and people have got preferences and so on. But if you look at 2011 and now, the tension, they are not at the same level. They are very isolated this time around. If you look at about 2,000 branches of the ANC, you probably saw Tshwane and Inchanga, which are not related, because Inchanga was more about the Communist Party meeting, not a meeting to select a candidate. But however, I think we are quite satisfied with the selection so far. But of course, we're dealing with the issues raised by comrades in Tshwane, because themselves, I don't think necessarily they needed to be raised in a manner they've raised in public. We're dealing with those issues. There are issues of selection, there are issues of preferences, and there's a way in which we can deal with issues of preferences, because everybody sees an opportunity to be a councillor.
Mm-hmm. So how does the selection process work, though?
Well, one of the most fundamental principles, which is not an option but a policy of the ANC, is that the candidate, whoever becomes a ward candidate, that person must have gone through a public community meeting. And that element is important, because in the past, we have had members of the ANC or members, branches of the ANC approving a candidate without that candidate going through the screening by the public. And we think a candidate, a councillor of the ANC, must enjoy first and foremost popularity within the community, within the ward. Because that person must be a hard-working person, that person must be known as a disciplined person in the community, that person must be loyal, must be the servant of the people. So therefore, on the basis of which that person will be elected, we think that criteria is important. But equally, we want people who are committed to serve the people, regardless of whatever they are popular. But if they don't committed to serve, they're not working, we don't think that candidate would be a good candidate for the community, must come from the ANC. So the ANC must select the best among its cadres to serve the community.
That candidate, is that candidate accountable to the community or to the president?
In the first instance, first and foremost, that candidate is accountable to the community, because that candidate is selected by the community. But politically and organizationally, that candidate, of course, would be accountable to the political party called the African National Congress if he or she comes from the African National Congress. But in first and foremost, given the fact that you are selected and elected by the community, you are accountable to the community.
Now, the ANC has been saying that the potential candidates will be paraded before the respective communities so that they can choose their preferred candidates. Is that what currently is happening in the branches?
I must say that across the length and breadth of the country, the reports we're getting is that our candidates are doing very well, and our branches do adhere to the prescript and the guideline requirement to have all BGMs of the ANC. Subsequent to that, all names must then be subjected to a community meeting. We're quite happy that so far there's been a very good progress, but however, a lot still needs to be done. Because from a national point of view, if a name comes out of a selection and it has not gone through a community meeting, we'll still send that name back, because we think an endorsement by the community is very important.
How are you dealing with factionalism within the organization so that it should not bear negative results after the elections?
Precisely the reason, the issues we identified in our last National General Council, that we don't want people who will come and be selected because they represent a particular group within the African National Congress. Because in the process, they get beholden to the groups that they represent. They don't represent the ANC. They don't represent the community. So it's important that in dealing with factions, part of why we introduce the community element is to deal with factions, so that whoever emerges out of the ANC process does not represent only one group in the ANC, represent the ANC, at the same time represent the broader interests of the community in the world.
Mm-hmm. As an organization, Mr. Kodwa, what are you doing in preparation for the upcoming local government elections to get people excited to vote for the African National Congress?
Well, we were busy with establishing structures over the period. We are now in the period of Maihlome, talking to our people, as you are aware that we are almost preparing to launch the manifesto, which is going to be a culmination of the hard work. We now have structures, we're busy with selection, and I think our people, the enthusiasm has reverberated throughout the length and breadth of the country. Our people are looking forward to vote in the African National Congress. As you are aware, we have also done what we called the assessment of the performance of the current councillors, because there's a certain percentage and a threshold, at least someone who has performed. We think that that community must be given an opportunity to make its own mind about who wants to lead that community. And we think we're satisfied that the preparation so far, including the enthusiasm among our people, is quite exciting. We think that going forward, there are a few things that we need to sort out in relation to finalization of the selection process.
Are there any areas of concern in terms of the local municipal elections, in terms of where you might fare badly?
Not at all. In fact, we are more confident that even in areas like Nelson Mandela, where there's been a lot of talk about ANC losing to any party, it would appear that the margins, including the surveys that are done, are giving a clear indication that, in fact, the ANC will retain all the metros that the ANC is governing at the moment, including Nelson Mandela, including Tshwane, including Johannesburg. We are working hard to increase our margins in terms of selection and election in those metros, as well as fighting to win Cape Town, where I am at the moment, the city of Cape Town, because we think that if given the work that we've done and given our work that we continue to do, we should be able to make sure that we win Cape Town back, because I think it's an important instrument to deliver and to de-racialize the sphere of Western Cape in terms of service delivery.
I see you avoided the name Tlokwe in that comment of yours.
No, clearly we have no doubt Tlokwe will win it overwhelmingly, regardless of what has happened in the past. People continue to have confidence in the ANC, and I think we will win Tlokwe overwhelmingly. No doubt that even the parties that continue to make noise, they know that the ANC enjoys overwhelming support in that municipality.
Mr. Kodwa, thank you so much for that update, and thank you for joining us in our Cape Town studios.